The Senate has the votes to reject President Donald Trump's border emergency. The House already opposed his declaration. Kentucky's Rand Paul is the fourth Republican to object to the president's move to transfer money from other federal funds to build the wall. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi joins us. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. 51 is the magic number. 51 senators need to vote to block the president's national emergency. So let's look at the math. There are 47 Democrats and independents. If all oppose, plus four Republicans, that means 51 votes, just enough to stop the president.
Senator Rand Paul supports the wall, but he's against the president's emergency declaration, writing, "The broad principle of separation of powers in the Constitution delegates the power of the purse to Congress." He's one of four Republicans opposing the president.
Do we want the executive branch, now or in the future, to hold the power that the founders deliberately entrusted to Congress?
President Trump defends himself.
And a lot of people talk about precedent, that if we do this, the Democrats will use national emergency powers for something that we don't want. They're going to do that anyway, folks. The best way to stop that is to make sure that I win the election. That's the best way to stop that.
The president's national emergency sets him up to move $3.6 billion from military construction funds to build the wall.
I'm very concerned with having murderers and drug traffickers and drugs and drug cartels pouring into our country.
But the House last week voted against the president's declaration.
The yeas are 245, the nays are 182.
They need to follow their heart. I'm just suggesting they take their brain with them.
Republican Senator John Kennedy says Congress already gave the president the authority.
I think we do have a crisis at the border. I would have preferred that we not have to use this option of a national emergency. I would prefer to have Congress do its job, but in my opinion, Congress didn't, and so the president's doing his.
The showdown forces Republicans to take a very hard vote. If they disapprove the president, it could hurt them with GOP voters. Now, if the Senate passes it, it would go to the president, and he's promised to veto it. Lauren?
So then will Congress override the veto? Probably not, right?
Congress is not likely to have the votes. 66 senators are needed to override the president's promised veto, plus 290 representatives. That's 45 short of what it got last week when it passed the House.
Capitol Hill correspondent and mathematician Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.